Hello and welcome to this presentation where we're going to take a more detailed look at user account controls and the separate logon sessions that the local security authority will create for privileged users. Here I'm logged on as Adam Carter. He's a domain administrator, so of course we'll be a local administrator on this machine. I have opened up a couple of programs, so I've got Internet Explorer and the Windows Explorer program open. And in Windows Explorer, I've mapped a network drive through to my domain controller. So the Z drive is pointing through to the data share on the domain controller. Well, let's start taking a little bit more detail of what that actually means. So let's open up a command prompt as Adam, the standard user. So we run command and just go to the Z drive, and probably we're not too surprised that it works. We would expect it to work. But would you expect this? So if I go through and run the command prompt again and right click and run as administrator, so we're still running as Adam, but we're now running with administrative privileges. The Z drive's not available. When Adam logged on, he created two logon sessions, or the local security authority created two sessions for him. These sessions are completely separate. Adam logs on, he's a privileged user, so he gets two access tokens. A filtered one, which is his day-to-day usage. This removes all of the group SIDs, the privileged group SIDs, and higher level rights assignments, and this is where the Z drive was mapped to. But he also has an unfiltered access token, which has then all of his privileged user group SIDs and all of his assigned rights. This is a completely separate logon, and he does not then have access through to the Z drive, whether it was done through Explorer or from the command line with NetUse. These are completely separate processes. So let's have a look using the sysinternals utility, logon sessions, of how we can actually view what's happening then internally on this system. I'll just increase the size of the font so we can see things a little bit more clearly. And we'll move through to the directory where I've installed logon sessions. So at the root of the C drive, logon sessions. This does need to run with administrative privileges, so I'm staying in Adam's administrative session. So we can see for Adam, he has two logon sessions. Essentially, one of these will be his administrative and one his non-administrative sessions. These sessions do not talk to each other. It's an undeniable security principle of Windows Vista, Windows 7, Windows 2008. So even though Adam can run tasks as administrator, he has to run them in his administrative ID. If we run the same command, logon session slash p, we can see then this is where I have my Explorer, Internet Explorer sessions open. This is my administrative session. So we have different processes running with each of these logon sessions, and they're kept secure. But remember, user account controls are not purely for administrative groups. It works for user rights assignments as well. So if I log on as an ordinary user, Spencer, Spencer does not currently have any additional rights through group memberships or assigned rights. But of course we can change that. So I'm going to run a command prompt for Spencer. And I'm going to run as administrator. And of course Spencer doesn't have rights, So I'm going to have to put in an administrative name and password. So I'm going to put in Adam's name and password. I'm just doing this because, again, I want access to the logon sessions program, which needs administrative privileges. So let's run logon sessions again. We can see that Spencer has a single logon session. He has just one access token. He doesn't need any more because he is just a standard user, an unprivileged account. Well, let's change that. Let's go into the local policy. We'll run this as an administrator again because, of course, Spencer wouldn't be able to change this. And we'll assign Spencer some additional privileges. So in the local group policy, I'm just going to navigate through to Windows, local policies, and the user rights assignments. We can see that there are several rights that are assigned just to the administrators, but these rights would also be seen as privileged if they've been passed through to things like the local service or the backup operators groups. So there's a few here. We can double click on them to see the membership, but we can also see who is a member just from the display here. So as we navigate down, we can see here that there's an increased processing working set or increased scheduling priority. So let's go through and add Spencer to the scheduling priority. So Spencer is still not really an administrator, he's just been given one additional permission. Of course, he's not going to get his new access token and those newly assigned user rights until we log on and log in again. It's the LSA that assigns the token at logon. So now when we try and run an administrative command prompt, the system is going to say, well, you could run it as Spencer, or I can run it as somebody else. Of course, running as Spencer wouldn't give me the privileges that I need to run logon session, so I will run as Adam. But we can see almost from this that there must be two security tokens for Spencer, because otherwise it wouldn't have prompted for Spencer's name and password. So if I run logon sessions again from the logon sessions directory, I can see now that Spencer has two logon sessions. Again, these are completely separate. The two sessions do not talk to each other. I hope you found this useful. And I hope you do not turn off user account control on your machines. Thank you very much, and we look forward to seeing you again soon.